And we're back again. We're going to go ahead and do a second video today, mainly because I actually have time. And also, it appears that my first video had a little bit of an issue because I didn't realize that my game volume was a lot higher than it should have been. So I ended up letting the game interrupt me when I was trying to say certain things. Whoops. Live and learn, right? And get loves. So we're going to go ahead and continue playing Dragon Priest again. Let's see if we can get a second victory. I'm doing all right, so we're going up against a rogue deck, so we'll see how that's going to work. Victory. Rogue for a long time has not been really good, from my understanding. When the game first started, it was good because of a Leroy Jenkins combo that got nerfed. And then, after all the nerfs happened with that list, it pretty much has been crap for a long time. And I think now it's become a little more interesting. There's this weird Death Rattle type deck that I actually have as well, or at least most of the cards for. It's actually kind of fun. I don't know if it's really good, but it is a lot of fun. So you might see me playing that eventually, at least my own version of it. Now, Rogue is typically the kind of deck that'll... There is two types I've seen. Some that are actually pretty aggressive, and then some that are a lot of... I play a lot of cards and get a lot of combos off, and all of a sudden I come out of nowhere and kill you kind of a thing. I'm going to stick with my basic strats for Dragon Priest, you know, use my spells to kill smaller creatures, and then just throw out some threats here and there. And I'm going up against Otto today. Now, unfortunately, I do not have anything to do this turn, which is really bad. I don't like not being able to play something on a given turn. Like, right now, I should have been able to play a 2-drop or maybe kill something, but I literally passed turn, and that's just not good. Okay. So he has a 4-4 out right now, which is really bad because I can't do nothing about that. So I'm about to just take 4 that are face, unfortunately. This looks like a losing mat battle here so far. I mean, when I was first picking my cards, I mean, they were all too expensive. So I got rid of that hand for a new hand. Not much better. And I'm actually going to move this camera a little bit because it appears to be in the way. You don't need to see who's online on anyway on my profile. Okay, so we're dealing with a 3-3 and a 4-4. I could kill the 3-3 right now by either paying 2 mana or using a coin to play this guy. And actually, I think I'd rather do this because this will actually put something on the board, finally. I wield the power of Black Wolf. Hopefully the volume is low enough to where it's not drowning out my talking this time. But I feel a little bit better now because I finally have something on the board. Of course, he's going to spend 5 mana to assassinate it. Yay. That's kind of the problem with some of Rogue's cards, is I think they're just too expensive for what they're worth. I mean, I get the point. You're supposed to play multiple spells and make things cheaper, whatever, but it just doesn't seem very consistent. Meanwhile, we're going to go ahead and play this dragon here. Azure Drake's really good. 4-4 for 5. Spell damage 1 is good. And you draw a card when he comes into play. Really good. This is just kind of a solid card in general. He's everything. It's one of those cards that you put in a deck just because it's good. Not necessarily because it fits, just because it's good. Now, in this case, he happens to fit because he's a dragon. I'll take it. Yeah, right now I'm getting my butt kicked. I literally spent turn 2 and 3 doing nothing. Like, turn 1 was perfect. You know, he played a creature, I killed it with a spell, dealing it 2 damage. Great. Turn 2 and 3, nothing. Just healing myself for two. And then turn four with coin, I was able to finally drop a threat and kill something. Now, granted, the enemy did kill it the very next turn, but that was actually perfectly fine, to be honest. I think by turn five, they should have been able to kill it, since I haven't really been throwing down any threats. Now, I'm thinking that my opponent just had connectivity issues, because they are not doing anything. Well, that's no fun. I was actually hoping to get a match here. But I am going to take advantage of it, because, what kind of a human being would I be if I didn't, take advantage of a game's glitch? Yeah, this might end up being one of those games I win only because of lag issues on their side. Now, if it was a lag issue on my side, then you would probably see it saying that I've been disconnected and something like that. This person probably got kicked out or something. I'm not sure. It's rather unfortunate, to be honest. Okay, he finally logged back in and realized that he wasn't doing so well. Let's see if I can actually squeeze in a third game. Why not? Well, I should say a second game on this video. I'm gonna try. Since that was kind of a quick match, I'll try to fit one more in. If not, I got some editing to do.
Shall bring victory.
When I'm picking my opening hand, I typically keep anything that costs four or less. And this is actually a really good hand. I have a dragon, and I have two creatures that cost two that are have synergy with dragons. It's a really good hand. No removal, but that's fine. I'll top deck it, I'm sure, when I need it. Ennobilis is what I'm playing now. Alright, so right now we're just gonna start with playing a creature with taunt. I could have played this little lady and got another dragon, but to be perfectly honest, I'd just rather put something semi-intimidating on the board. Yeah, I said semi. I'm actually gonna kill the 1/1 with a creature just because Paladin has a bad habit of, giving it +3 and a me, and I don't like that crap. So, I don't really want to put anything too expensive in my hand right now. This is still early game, so I'm just going to pick something cheaper. So, I have three, four drops. That kind of worked out, I guess. Alright, so. And again, this isn't one of your tier list Paladin decks. We are still rank 20 right now, I believe. So, you're not gonna see, anything too crazy, I don't think. You'll see something maybe random that doesn't belong. Like that 3/1 you just played for three. I don't usually see that too many good Paladin lists. I should also let you know that I used to play, a while back, a long time ago, like a little bit after the game came out on Android. And I actually stopped playing for a while, just because I didn't have time. And he made my attack one. That makes me sad. Well, I could put it back in my hand. Yeah, maybe one day. For now, we're just gonna drop a Drake. Why not? A Twilight Guardian, to be specific. But I did stop playing for a few months, and when I came back, all of a sudden there was a standard format. I'm like, oh, way to go ahead and copy Wizards of the Coast Blizzards. Standard, huh? But no, actually, there's a lot of card games out there that have, different modes, standard. I think Magicka has EDH, which I used to play. I did play Magic the Gathering a long time ago. I am quote-unquote retired. I actually don't want to play a creature right now.
That minion already
Yeah, I
attacked.
really don't. I don't like to overextend that, and this is the only dragon in my hand, which means I lose synergy with these two guys. So far, this guy hasn't played nothing very, anything worth really killing with this, so unless I'm only, I don't think that I'm gonna need this a lot. I got a lot of control in my hand right now. Yeah, I used to
Reporting
play
for
Magic the
duty.
Gathering for a good 10 years. Went to a few Pro Tours, Grand Prix, things like that. Now, I'm not like, a great player or anything like that. Like I mentioned in my first video, I mainly play for fun, but I always get a lot of pride when I go to a major event like a Grand Prix. I take some fun deck, some unique idea, because like I said, I've always been casual. I always build decks that are fun for me that have synergy, and it's nice
Your faith
to,
in the light.
That's a dramatic entrance right there. But I like to go like say 8-2 with some fun deck. I mean, it just makes me feel good about myself, I guess. Speaking of feeling good about myself, we're gonna go ahead and put that in my deck because he is that good. Put your faith in the light. That's the one thing I like about Paladin is there's a lot of the creatures are kind of overacting, and I love the overacting. Like that stuff just tickles me. I love it. Hoping I can finish this pretty quickly because it's kind of running on time here. Oh, now he wants to play a bunch of spells, and I'm starting to run out of time. Okay. Well, let's see. That's rather unfortunate. Oh, wait, what am I thinking? This is actually not bad at all. Oh, forgot that was still alive. Misplay! Oh, yeah, patron. I used to play Patron Warrior back in the old days. Oh, man, I used to piss so many people off. Oh, what the heck. I need to win quickly. Normally, I wouldn't play that right now, but I'm just trying to win now. This is probably going to cause me to lose. This is why you never rush plays. But I'm trying to squeeze in two games in one video. Is he seriously trying that again? Okay, well, GG. Oh, Black Wing. All right. Boom, and that's rank 20, everybody. We're now on rank 19. So on my next set of videos, I'll try to continue to finish the goal. Free victory. I'll take it. And yeah, we're going to go ahead and continue playing Dragon Priest until he just gets too old. And we'll switch to another fun list. Because as you can see, since I have a few seconds left, I have a lot of different list that I have, and most of them are just fun, nothing really net deckish that people like to call it. So you'll be seeing me play some pretty fun, interesting decks. And then if you have any, ideas, let me know in the comments. Well, we'll see you guys next time.